two high school boys basketball teams with a combined record of 23 wins and just two losses meet in TB3's Game of the Week. Newcastle and Connersville Trojans versus Spartans, the Game of the Week on TB3. Hi everybody and welcome to Spartan Bowl and to a basketball game between the Newcastle Trojans and Connersville Spartans. These two teams are used to winning. Newcastle's record is 10 wins and 1 loss. The Spartans even better. They've won 13 ball games and lost 1. With Ron Wiley, this is Fran Schimmel. Ron, this game has all of the ingredients of a great contest.
Oh, absolutely. The ingredients of a great ball game. You speak of ingredients, you think of food, you think of hunger, and Newcastle is hungry because we beat them on their floor twice last year. They were up 11 in the fourth quarter of that game, that first game. We came back and won by 9, and then, of course, we beat them for the sectional title on their floor. They're hungry to get revenge tonight, and I tell you what, it's a very dangerous team to be facing, but we're hungry as well. We haven't been on this floor in over a month.
We had 9 road games, and as you say, it's been a while.
Yeah, it's been a long time, and again, these boys are excited to be back here in the friendly confines of this fine historic arena, and they're hungry to be performing in front of this hometown hysteria, the Spartan faithful.
Another great crowd here tonight. Newcastle's one loss was December 16th, a double overtime loss to Mount Vernon High School at Fortville. Final score was 79-77. The Spartans, playing in a holiday tourney at Richmond, lost to Portage 69-56. That was on December 27th. How do you win this game? We asked Spartan head coach Kerry Brown. Coach, 9 road games. You won 8 of them. That's not bad.
Yeah, overall, we had a good road trip, road experience, if you will. But we're glad to be back home. I think it's been about since December the 17th since we last played here. So it's good to be back in the confines of Spartan Bowl.
No place like home.
None at all. We're glad to be back, and especially tonight, we're hoping that the home court helps us with a win tonight against a really good Newcastle team.
What are the keys to this game?
Well, you know, offensively, if we keep shooting the ball like we have recently, we've shot it really well. That's going to help us. And then defensively, they're going to challenge us. They're going to stretch us. We're going to have to be in two places at one time. We're going to have to help in the post on their big kids. And we're going to have to get back out to the perimeter and still be able to contest shots. You know, I think whichever team probably ends up defending and then rebounding the best will come out on top tonight.
I know you want to rebound and you want to cut down on any turnovers.
Yeah, I mean, we've done a pretty good job all season. Our last two opponents were more of an athletic teams and more of a pressing,
yes,
trapping team. So we had a couple more than we were averaging earlier in the year, but that's to be expected when you play someone as athletic as Louisville Ballard and Muncie Central. Newcastle's going to get after us, but they're not quite as athletic as either one of those two teams.
You know, I really, looking at the Spartans and Newcastle, they almost mirror each other.
Well, I don't know what their points per game is. I just hope when the night's over with, it's about 20 points less than what it normally is. I think they're averaging around 67.
Yeah,
we're probably not quite that high. Our defensive average might be a little bit better than theirs.
Yes.
I'm not sure what their defensive average is. But, you know, some of that has to do with who you play. And then some of it has to do with the style that they choose to play against you that night. Like early in the year, we've had some teams that came out and played very patient against us, which holds your offensive average down. It also holds your defensive average down. So, but when teams have come out and played us and run up and down the floor, I think overall we've done a pretty good job of executing in the offensive end. And we've shot the ball really well, especially the last,
yes,
few games. So I hope I don't jinx us, but we've got 3 kids shooting over 40% from the three-point line for the year. As a team, we're shooting from two-point range 57%. And on the season, we're shooting total field goals 49%. So we're doing some good things.
Player movement and ball movement, I know you like that.
Yeah, I think, you know, the more of those you get, the easier it is to break down the defense. The other key for us is we have young men who are willing to share the basketball and make the extra pass. You know, Grant's been our leading scorer most of the season, yet the last two games he's been in double figures,
yes,
with assists. So we don't care who scores it. You know, we're taking advantage of what the defense has given us.
Coach, that one game you lost, the holiday tourney with Portage, was it the second half the defense didn't hold up?
Well, you know, in the first half, they had one young man that had 20 points on us. And then in the second half, we came out and we got behind and we had to press. And it's not something we've worked on a whole lot, so they took advantage of that. You know, they were just the better team at that time. We just, you know, it is what it is. We were down one at halftime.
Yes.
And just didn't come out and get it done in the second half. And I can give you a number of reasons, but they're all excuses. You know, we just didn't get it done that night. So it was a great learning experience for our kids. I think we've come out since then, and we've played really well.
I was going to ask you if it was the kids understood that they had to play better to win.
Well, you know, I think sometimes it's easier to get their attention after a loss than it is a win. You can tell the kids we need to do better at this, but if you win a game by 15, 20, 30 points, it really doesn't resonate with them. But if you get beat, then it seems to resonate a little bit more. So there's lessons that can be learned. You just want to learn them all before you get to the tournament so that, you know, you're still not teaching once the tournament starts. But, you know, we've got things that we can improve on.
Kid, Coach, good luck at number 14.
Thank you.
Here are the starting lineups, Ron.
Yes, for the Newcastle Trojans, a very tall, very big lineup. They are led by Luke Bumbelow. He's a 6-foot sophomore. He's number 3 at one of the guard positions. David Frogel is a 6-foot sophomore. He's at the other guard position. He's number 10. And this is where they get big, Fran. At one of the forward positions is Nia Williamson. He's a 6'2 junior, number 20. And their two bigs at the other forward position is Titan Bennett. He's a 6'6 sophomore. He's a senior. He's number 45. And Mason Gillis, he's a 6'6 sophomore. That guy's the guy to watch. He's number 32, and he's at one of the center positions. They also have a 6'5 guy on the bench. So they are definitely loaded with height and speed and talent. Newcastle Trojans.
Some football players.
You're absolutely right. For the Connersville Spartans, they are led by Garrett Silcott. He's a 6-foot junior, number 12 at one of the guard positions. Noah Belts, a 6'4 sophomore. He's a guard. He's number 30. Grant Smith in the front court is leading the Spartans. He's a 6'6 senior. He's number 40. Dalton Huffman clogs up the center. He's a 6'3 senior, number 50. And Bo Isaacs is a 6'4 senior. He's at one of the four positions at number 52.
Okay, the starting fives and teams are leaving the floor right now. They'll be returning shortly. They've had a meeting of the co-captains with the officials a few minutes ago. The captains for the Spartans tonight are Garrett Silcott, Grant Smith, and Bo Isaacs. Newcastle and the Spartans have four common opponents. Both have wins over Shelbyville. Newcastle by 10 points. The Spartans by 2 in an overtime game. Both beat Richmond, Newcastle by 3 points. The Spartans beat Richmond by 5. Royceville, Newcastle won by 32 points, and the Spartans by 30. And they both beat Greenfield Central, Newcastle by 16 points, and the Spartans by 7. Newcastle averages scoring 66.2 points a game. The Spartans 58.3. Defensive averages are 52.5, Newcastle, and 44.7, Connersville. Last season, the Spartans played Newcastle twice. Ryan and I talked about that, winning the regular season game 75-66 and the championship game of the sectional 63-55 on March 5th. Quite a night, Ron.
Yeah, definitely that was a great night as these boys finally brought home a sectional title. We hadn't had one since before they were born, so they definitely want to have that feeling again, especially Bo and Grant and the other seniors who are walking out here. They definitely want to have that repeat feeling again, but first we got to score to settle with Newcastle and continue that win streak and put on a show here for the faithful tonight.
That was a memorable game, and TV3 was happy to be there,
there a year ago,
and hopefully maybe we could have a rematch this year. Who knows?
I would love
Newcastle
that.
And the Spartans clash in the section at Newcastle. The officials for tonight's game are Gary Hamilton from Franklin, Chris Fuller from Noblesville, and David George, he's from Fishers. We are minutes away from the opening tip, Connersville Spartans and the Newcastle Trojans. Ryan and I will be returning with the beginning of this TV3 Game of the Week. Just a reminder, you are watching Spartan basketball on TV3.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Spartan Bowl for tonight's varsity game featuring the Newcastle Trojans and our own Connersville Spartans. Now let's meet the rosters for both teams here this evening. For Newcastle, wearing number 4, Bryce Huntley. Number 11, Clayton Burress. Number 22, Wes Chamberlain. 24, Clay McDaniel. Number 30, Garrett Welch. Number 33, Nicholas Geezer. Number 40, Bryce Webb. Number 42, Jared Hurd. And number 52, Matthew Dickerson. Starting lineup for the Trojans. At forward, wearing number 20, Naya Williamson. At forward, number 45, Titan Bennett. At center, number 32, Mason Gillis. At guard, number 3, Luke Bumalo. And at guard, number 10, David Rowe. Newcastle coached by Daniel Cox.
Thank you.
Spartan Bowl in Connersville, scene of the action tonight. The Newcastle Trojans in their traveling green uniform. Spartans, of course, in their home whites with red trim, and we are just about to begin. Number 32, Mason Gillis, a 6'6 sophomore, will be jumping center for the visitors. And for the Spartans, it will be Grant Smith, a 6'6 senior. First ball game tonight was a loss by the JV team, and we'll talk more about that a little bit later on.
Yeah, it's very exciting in this place, I tell you. you got electricity personified is going on in this place right now, and this is, it's almost feel like sectional championship part A.
Tip controlled by the guys in green as it goes into backcourt, bringing it across the timeline. Number 3, Luke Bumbala. He's a sophomore at Newcastle High School, handling the ball right now. The Spartans in their man-to-man defense.
You know, speaking of defense, how will the defense stack up? Our defense has been phenomenal all year long. This is a bigger team, a quicker team, one of the fastest and biggest teams we've played so far this year. How will we stack up defensively?
Well, Ron, we talked with Coach Brown in the pregame about the ball movement and player movement, and we'll see plenty of that tonight from both teams.
Yeah, they've had the ball, you know, 45 seconds close, well, 40 seconds right now, and they haven't even taken a shot, and that just tells you how good our defense is.
Makes you wonder if what kind of a ball game they're going to play here tonight at Spartan Bowl.
Well, they're going to try to do
man
that.
Underneath, and oh, close in shot missed by their 45, their 6'6 senior, Titan Bennett, and the Spartans grab the rebound, so maybe they'll get the first basket of this game.
Well, I tell you what, right now, the Spartans, you know, got it. That was an inside shot, and that
they
didn't work.
The ball underneath.
Not good at all.
Loose ball picked up by a Newcastle player, and quickly they're across the timeline. Here's 10 firing a three from behind the free throw circle. David Froge, sophomore at Newcastle High. A 13.3 per game average, so the Trojans do get the first points of this ball game.
Yeah, he did that last year during the sectional. You know, he made some threes, and, you know, we got an answer.
Oh, Isaacs tries a long shot, miss. Grant Smith grabs the rebound in traffic, gives off to Dustin Hoffman, and is off his fingertips, and down court, Newcastle. They're controlling turnover here tonight, causing the Spartans all sorts of problems.
There
quickly
he goes.
Up court is Silcott. He'll crash into a Newcastle player, and the foul, I believe, will be called on the guy in green.
Absolutely. That right there, Garrett Silcott, he has to take over this game. He's going to have to start doing a lot of driving. We need to get there. Biggs in trouble. And he, you know, he's almost automatic at the line.
Foul's called on Bennett. Silcott at the line for a couple of free throws. First one is good.
Yeah, we need Garrett to get inside and, you know, pitch it out to Bo if need be, but get inside and draw those fouls and get these free buckets. That's not
second
good.
Second one is off the front of the rim and drops into the hands of a Newcastle player. Bringing across the line is Froge, along with the other guard, number 3, Bumbalaw.
You know, Gillis has gotten inside a couple of times and has missed it.
There's a missed cue by the Trojans, and the Spartans grab the basketball, but give it right back.
Yeah, just, you know,
can't have that wrong.
Yeah, just forcing the issue too much right there. Just slow down a little bit.
45 fires long for Newcastle. Misses. High to grab the rebound is the Spartans' leading rebounder, number 40, Grant Smith. He's up court. Gets within 5 feet of the basket. Puts one up and in as he banks it up and in.
Yeah, that was a great play right there by Grant Smith as he's all fired up as he got inside, didn't hesitate, and got the kiss off the glass.
We're tied at 3 as Newcastle puts it in play. Number 20 works the ball into his teammate. That's Gillis. Shot from out by Newcastle is missed. Spartans grab the rebound. Up court is Smith.
Oh, I thought
Isaacs,
Bo was going to take
I thought
that.
He
yeah.
was set for the play. Hands off to Noah Belt, who stumbles a little bit, but keeps control of the ball. Gets to Silcott. Here's Isaacs firing, missing.
Yeah,
don't see that very often, Ron.
No, you don't see that very often at all from Bo.
He
but you
hit, he didn't get it to the rim.
Yeah, that's not going to stop him from shooting, though. Not at all.
No, he's a great three-point shooter. Newcastle in control. Number 10 fires and misses. That shot by Froge. Rebounding, again, the Spartans. Spartans controlling the board.
They could take those shots all night long because, I mean, you got Gillis and their bigs there away from the glass.
So we'll
take it off. But we got to make them pay.
Here's Smith. The turnaround shot from the free throw lane is missed. He is on the floor. Newcastle has the ball down court. A reverse layup put up and in by number 32, Gillis.
Yeah, that's his third inside shot, and he finally made one.
He has a 14.4 per game average. Puts his team up by two points. Here are the Spartans on the attack.
Here we go.
Oh, Bell underneath. Yeah. Nice feed to Noah Bell. Drives the baseline from the right side. Puts it up and in, and we're tied at five.
Yeah, that's not somebody you expect to get inside. And Noah just, they fell asleep, and he saw it.
He went in there. Got the under defense. There's a crazy shot by Newcastle.
Yeah, they're going to call that on Dalton, or as you like to call him, Dustin. So we'll.
I'm bound to change his name.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. That's the first foul of the ball game against the Spartans, sending to the free throw line, Gillis.
Yeah, Dalton had his hands up. He didn't think he made any contact.
Free throw will bounce on the rim and finally drop in. Huffman will come out, and Mason Sullenberger will be replacing him. Mason, a 6'3 senior. Here's the second free throw coming up. Meanwhile, Kerry Brown has a conversation with one of the officials. Second free throw is missed. Smith grabs a rebound for Connersville.
Yeah, Kerry said something to the Zebra as he walked past him. Not sure what he's talking about other than, Dalton looked like he played perfect defense on that. That's probably what Kerry's getting into the
Here's
grill.
Smith's firing long and missing, and the rebound comes to Newcastle.
You know, when we have Grant take those outside shots, we're really behind in
shot
height.
By Newcastle, miss. This will stop play. He's on number 45. That's his second, I believe.
Yeah, that's Bennett's. I wasn't quite sure what the foul was.
I'm sure the Newcastle coach is unhappy about that because Bennett is a 6'6 senior with a 10-point per game average. He is taking a seat, and his replacement will be number 42. That will be Jared Hurd. Sullenberger takes the inbound pass. Spartans set up the play. Newcastle, here's Bo Isaacs right now. Gets around his man, puts it up and in, and the Spartans have their first lead of the ball game.
Yeah, that was beautiful from Bo right there.
Yes.
Did not hesitate 1 ounce or 1 second on that.
He just went around the man guarding him and put it up and in. Here's a jumper for 2 points by Bumbleaw from just outside the free throw circle. Newcastle up by a point. Here come the Spartans. Silcott works it across the timeline, the point guard. Sullenberger, Isaacs, back to the basket, will feed out the belt. Goes to Smith.
This is one of those ball games where every offensive series is important.
You're right.
And that's why you got to take your time a little bit. I mean, this may favor Newcastle with the pace we're on.
Here's Belt driving the baseline, losing control. Picked up by Newcastle. Shot is missed, but he's tipped up and in by a trophy. Foul call, too.
I'm going to call.
Called no on that.
No on that one, yeah.
Noah Belt, his first, team second. And the fellow that made the field goal gets a free throw. This is Gillis. Drops it in. 3-point play for the Trojans. 11-7 they're up. And 6 of those points belong to Gillis.
Yeah, right now, we're just playing, our offensive is, we're not set. We're making way too many mistakes. Way too many mistakes. Got to settle it down a little bit.
There's Silcott taking a
losing
the ball.
Yeah.
A player on the floor is a Newcastle boy. The official waits for him to get up to see his number. It's going to be a foul call.
Yeah, definitely was a
number 10, Froge. Non-shooting foul. Silcott will inbound for Connersville.
You know, and again, I like that. I like, you know, the aggressiveness there from Garrett getting inside, drawing that foul.
Ball comes into Smith in the corner.
Ooh, nice hit.
Left side, drives down, pops one up from about 4 feet away, and it's good. He's fouled.
Yeah, he's fouled right there. Again, beautiful, not hesitating. One step, 1 second, and got inside there. And beautiful job there from Grant.
3 points for Smith, and the Spartans pull within a point. 5 for Grant so far tonight. Here's 20 firing long and missing, and the rebound goes to Connersville.
Again, another defensive board right here. Hunter, here we go. Oh, man.
Hunter Sullenberger tries a long shot, missed. No Spartan under the basket, so the rebound grabbed by Newcastle. Here's Gillis going over to Froze. Number 3, Bumbleaw, got a man underneath, and it will not drop for Newcastle. Close-in shot, a high percentage shot.
Yeah.
They've missed some of those tonight. Oh, and Sullenberger gets behind the defense of Newcastle under the basket.
Yeah.
Spartans work the ball to him. He lays it up and in, and CHS goes up by a point.
Yeah, you know, we've had a lot of inside, you know, baskets like that. Sullenberger, Barker, the right place at the right time, and you know, gives us the lead as, you know, this is definitely going to take the last shot right here. Got to stop them.
Yeah, they had just seconds remaining in the first period.
You know, to think how bad offensively we've played so far, Fran, with a lot of mental mistakes, a lot of mental turnovers, to have the lead right now is great.
Here's a shot which will
go
through. That's a three-pointer. Then the buzzer sounds by Newcastle's Luke Bumbleaw. Well, an exciting first period, Ron.
Oh, that's an incredible first period.
12 with Newcastle on top of the Spartans after the first 8 minutes of play. But as you point out, the Spartans have made some costly mistakes.
Yeah, very costly mistakes. You know, getting inside and you know, just not playing with smarts. We kind of slowed it down a little bit there for a while where we were playing, you know, not forcing the issue, but being aggressive, but not being too aggressive. We were too aggressive in the beginning. That made them, you know, get easy baskets from our steals. And again, we got to make them pay whenever we get the glass and cut out those mistakes.
Daniel Cox is the coach at Newcastle. He's in his fourth year. He has 45 wins and 34 losses. The Spartans, Kerry Brown is in his eighth year with 109 wins and 75 losses.
Kerry Brown, you know, again, it's hard to believe he's been here 8 years for the Spartans and, you know, finally brought back a sectional title that's been eluding us for such a long time. The faithful enjoy him as the coach. Kids, you know, rally around him. And you hardly ever see him get flustered, you know, during the ballgame. He may get in the grill of the Zebras, but Kerry's a pretty calm, collected guy.
He may be going apart on the inside, but he doesn't show it
too much.
Spartans will inbound as we begin the second period of play.
Cut out the mistakes. Don't
Grant
be too
Smith
aggressive.
With the ball. Silcott dribbles behind the free throw circle. Back to Smith. Cross court to Isaacs. Out to Silcott.
You know, we got to think, too. We talk about the mental mistakes we made, but, you know, Gillis has missed a lot of inside shots. So,
yes, absolutely.
You know, we could be down farther than
There's
two.
A shot by Sullenberger from the corner, which is just short. Drops off the rim, and a Newcastle guy has it.
Yeah, that was just being out-hustled.
Bumbleaw brings it up court. Feeds off, and a shot missed from out by Newcastle's Mason Gillis. The rebound goes to Connersville.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind him shooting that all day long.
Going into tonight's game, Ron, Grant Smith has 134 rebounds.
Oh, that's incredible.
And
that's unbelievable. He's
had five or six tonight, I think. There's a shot which is missed and is pulled off the rim by Newcastle's Gillis.
Boy, Gillis just went much taller than Sullenberger. It showed right there.
Here's Newcastle's number 10 firing and missing. They don't hit from the out very well.
No, not at all.
I shouldn't say that. They'll probably start dropping them in from every place.
Wow,
there's another shot off the mark by Bo Isaacs, another three.
Yeah, he's not going to stop, though. He's going to keep shooting. Bo's a shooter.
Newcastle, after the rebound, brings it up court. up by a couple of points here. And
I'm so surprised at how their bigs are just so far away from the, I mean, now you got, you know, Gillis inside, but not, I mean, they're so far out.
This is shot from out, which is good. Another three by Bumbleaw, and the Trojans go up 17 to 12. 8 points for Bumbleaw. He's just a sophomore at Newcastle. Martin now down by the biggest margin, 5 points. Silcott drives around a couple of defenders, lays it up and in on the right side.
We're going to have a lot more of that from Garrett. Get inside again, try to draw the foul, if not take a bucket from, you know, from wherever he's at. I mean, that, you know, he's got to get inside.
Yeah, he'll penetrate their defense.
Oh, yeah.
Give him the slightest of openings.
Absolutely. I mean, that kid, you don't need much.
3-point lead for Newcastle. Shot from the side is good. And they go up by five.
You know, if you remember the sectional championship on their floor last year, you know, they came out hot that first quarter, quarter and a half, made a lot of threes, and they were ahead for a while.
Yes.
And then we just took off. And right there's another one. There it is.
There's a blocking foul as Silcott drives the lane. He'll be at the line for a fair.
Yeah, again, that's what we need right there is him getting to the line.
Now it's going to be called on number 30, Welch of Newcastle, his first, team's fifth. At the line is Silcott.
Garrett. He's off this year.
It's unusual for Garrett.
Yeah, it's unusual for him to miss. He was in the 80s last year, and I think he's, you know, lower this year, obviously.
Well, he's in the 11.6 per game average. His second free throw will drop through for the Spartans' 15th point, cutting the lead of Newcastle to five. Silcott with four. Here come the Trojans. They've won three straight ball games since their loss. The Spartans have won five games since their loss in that holiday tourney. There's a loose ball. Newcastle player hits the deck, but passes off to a teammate. Number three, Bumbleaw, jump shot from the free throw circle is good. And that kid's hot. The Spartans defenders are going to have to quiet him down some lot as the Spartans fall down by seven.
Yeah, he can. You can't give him those shots.
Spartans working the ball right now, trying to penetrate this defense of Newcastle.
If any guy can do it, this guy right here.
Spartans just aren't operating on all cylinders yet. Here's number 12 firing and hitting a three from the corner. That is Silcott. 7 points for Garrett tonight.
Yeah, you get him inside, get him outside. Doesn't matter. When you're hot, you're hot.
Here come the Trojans setting up the play. Number 20 with the ball. Feeds off to three.
That guy's on fire.
Once again, that Bumbleaw guy. I mean, and Kerry Brown wants a timeout. He's going to have to switch defense on that kid to cool him off as they go out in front 25 to 18. The Trojans over the Spartans here at Spartan Bowl tonight.
Yeah, you know, again, they've had one, two, three, four, five three-pointers right now. That's 15 of their 25 points have been from behind the line. And again, you want them to take those low-percentage shots. But, you know, when they're making them, we got to start sticking a hand in the face.
That's right.
And we're not doing that.
Have to have hands-up defense to try to cool this team down a little bit.
Yeah, and it definitely, you know, Kerry said that, you know, you got to stick to the guy. You got to have, you know, can't give them any space whatsoever. They're hot. Got to somehow try to get the momentum back.
Smith will trigger it in for Connorsville, and Silcott will move it into front court.
You know, we've seen games like this, Fran, where, you know, we've just really not fired on all cylinders that first half, and then we've been able to make the adjustments. Defensively, we're you know, always there. It's just that, again, we got to make sure that we have a hand in the face if they're going to be this hot.
Smith with the ball for Connorsville. Works to Belt. Back out to Smith. Man-to-man defense by this Newcastle team. Here's Silcott driving the baseline, feeding off to a teammate. Huffman is back in the game. There's a shot missed and a rebound taken off by Newcastle.
Again, missing some easy bunnies. Both teams have missed some inside shots. Of course, Dalton was a little contested there, but still I like the effort to get inside like that. Just, you know, got to get it to fall.
Castle on the attack along the baseline.
I thought there was a walk somewhere.
I thought he walked a few times too.
Yeah, that was unbelievable.
The official apparently.
Yeah, apparently you're
allowed
to slide.
Ignored it or didn't see it, I'm not sure.
Yeah, the official was explaining to Carey that you know, it wasn't his pivot foot that slid.
Bryce Huntley is number four, was triggered in for the Trojans off the bench. Here's number three. Boy, there's that Bumbleaw kid, and he has a two-pointer this time, a jump shot from the free throw, just outside the free throw circle. He has 15 points, Ron.
Yeah. I mean, he's just on fire. And you know, eventually you're going to go out, and there's Grant inside.
There's
and miss.
Smith trying a shot, beautiful missing job. It, but tapping it up and in. And the Spartans get a field goal. 7 points for Grant Smith tonight. Spartans down by seven with 2 minutes left to play in the opening half.
I was going to say, where there's the walk finally.
By Newcastle.
I kind of hesitated there, Fran. I thought he was going to call a foul on somebody.
I thought, well, that's a makeup for that.
Yeah, right.
He missed.
Yeah, just a minute ago.
Here's Chilcott across the timeline for the Spartans.
You know, again, definitely have to make them pay for that mistake right there. Got to get some points right now. Bo's going to be the man.
Finally hits a three. That's his third try. So this one is good. He has 5 points. And the Spartans have 23, but they're down by four.
Yeah, Bo's a shooter. Again, he's not going to let some bad shots. That was crazy.
Well, that was number three. Drove between a couple of Spartans. That Bumbleaw kid. What's that, about 17 points?
17 points here for Bumbleaw. I mean, that kid.
17 of their 29.
Yeah, they're going to call a foul.
No, this will stop play.
Yeah, they got number four away from the ball. And that I thought that was seven for him, but that's six. One more, we're at the line.
That's on Huntley of Newcastle. Spartans inbound, their end of the floor. Comes into backcourt to Belt.
I don't think Grant meant to throw that far back.
Not sure that was intended. Chilcott has the basketball. We have a little over a minute to go in this opening half. Here's Smith, rims the basket and drops off as it was a corner shot. Would have been a three, but it was not to be, and Newcastle will call for a timeout.
Yeah, I don't know what they're calling a timeout for, but right now, obviously, the momentum is clearly on the side of Newcastle. I mean, they're just doing, you know, they're firing on all cylinders, especially Bumbleaux. I mean, this guy, you know, hit from 3 points, able to drive inside, and you know, he's a force to be reckoned with. But again, he's their only force. Everyone else has kind of been contained. We just got to stop him.
Braxton Reveille will come in to the lineup for Connersville. Let's see who he'll be replacing.
Finally got Bo off the snide with that three. You know, we just got to, you know, again, just calm down and relax. This ball game is far, far, far from over.
Again, Huffman will come out of the ball game.
You know, we were down 11 in the fourth quarter on their floor.
Yes.
Last year when we played them the first time.
Newcastle sets up the play with a minute on the clock here in the opening half. Trojans up by 6 points. Looking the ball. It appears right now they're going to go for the final shot.
Yeah, it looks like it. I mean, and why not? I mean, they're up six. Don't want to lose any momentum going into the locker room. But we definitely need to force a turnover.
Spartans falling back on defense, just letting Newcastle eat the clock.
Yeah, and again, why not for Newcastle? I mean, they're sure. Up six, and that's where you want to be going into the locker rooms, at least up two buckets.
I'll bet number three tries the final shot, Ron.
He'll probably shoot it from there.
He only has 17 so far.
Yeah, he can make it from there. I mean, this guy, look, you got to get in that guy's face.
Yeah, Silcott's got the job of guarding him. Here he goes. Missing. Whistle stops the play with 2 seconds on the clock. He's going to call a foul.
Yeah.
On Reveille. They got Reveille of Connersville. That will give Newcastle the ball out of bounds with 2 seconds on the clock in the first half. Well, they're going to work it into number three. Guess what? He fires, and it's going to be short.
I'm shocked.
That's the first time he's missed.
I know. I can't believe it.
I think he missed because a Spartan defender had his,
that's right,
had his hand up in his face.
Hand in his face.
It caused him to miss the ball. We played a half here tonight at Spartan Bowl. Newcastle has the lead of 29-23 over the CHS Spartan. 29 Newcastle, Connersville 23 at halftime. What's the scoring look like, Ron?
Well, for the Newcastle Trojans, it's all Luke Bumbalo. He's got 17 of their 29 points. David Fogle has 6, and Mason Gillis has 6 for the Newcastle Trojans. For the Connersville Spartans, they are led by Garrett Silcott and Grant Smith, 7 points apiece. Hunter Sutherland, Barker, and Noah Belt each have 2, and Bo Isaacs has 5 for the Spartans, 23 points.
Bumbalo Kid's a one-man wrecking crew.
Yeah, definitely one-man wrecking crew. I mean, he's one of those guys that, he shot from the outside. He was able to get inside. He was just all over the floor and doing it right. We've just never had an answer for him. The key is to, get a hand in the face because when they're shooting outside, that's, again, the low percentage shot. That's what we want. We were able to get the glass when they did miss, but we offensively did not fire on all cylinders at all. We were struggling. We were being too aggressive, making mental mistakes that we hardly ever had made this year. So, again, calm down, relax. Let's calm the ship. Let's slow down and play our style of basketball, and we'll be back right in this ball game.
Spartans will make some changes, I think, during halftime.
Yeah,
Gary Brown knows what's wrong, and he'll correct it.
Yeah, he'll definitely correct it. Again, be more sticky defense on the 3 points. Be in the face. And the reason why they didn't get that last shot off is because we were in their face. And, we need to do that. And we also definitely, without question, need to stop making mental mistakes. Those costly turnovers, we got to stop making them.
Junior Spartans lost a tough game in the opener here tonight. Only their fourth loss of the season. They've won 10 times, but they lost to the Newcastle JV team 45-41. Newcastle, they led all stops, and the Junior Spartans lost, as we mentioned, game number 4. They tried to play catch up. They were down quite a few points, cut it to 2-4, but still lost. It was a tough loss, but Newcastle's JV team looked
They looked very good. I mean, and our JV has looked very good as well. So, we got a bright future, both teams do. So this rivalry can only get better and get more intense.
We're at halftime here tonight at Spartan Bowl. Newcastle Trojans 29, the Connersville Spartans 23. In this game from Spartan Bowl, it is the TV3 game of the week. A reminder, you are watching Spartan basketball on TV3. Eight minutes on the clock as we begin the third period of play here tonight at Spartan Bowl. The Newcastle Trojans, who lead in this ball game by 6, will put it in play. It comes in to Luke Bumbalo, the leading scorer this ball game, 6-foot sophomore at Newcastle High School. There's a play broken up by the Spartans. Fast break down court, and a whistle stopped play somewhere along.
They stopped play. Garrett was fouled, and boy, I tell you about Grant, had his eyes wide open on that one.
He was fast breaking down court and was ready for a layup when the whistle sounded.
He was ready
Spartans
for a slam.
Spartans will have the basketball on the turnover by Newcastle after they inbound to start this second half. See if the Spartans can cut into that lead. Here is Smith passing off to Belt. Back out to Smith. He's behind the free throw circle. Starts to drive, goes to Silcott.
Again, one thing we didn't do was make them pay when they made their turnovers. When we got the defensive glass, they walked.
There's Smith trying a jumper from the free throw lane, called for traveling.
Yeah, can't not do that. He had a few of those during, watch it right here, kind of skids and jump.
These turnovers can really cost you, Ron. Now it gives Newcastle you lose a chance to score, and Newcastle has a chance to score.
Yeah, and right now being down 6, every turnover, just really digs more of the hole that we're in.
Absolutely, it's very important. Here's number 10 firing, missing, and a tap up and missed by Newcastle. So they're a little bit cold as we begin this period. There's a jumper from the free throw lane by Smith. He makes up for that last time down court.
Yeah, that's what he was trying to do last time, you know, get him within 5-10 feet, and he was able to do that very successfully.
Yeah, the Trojans on the attack with a lead of four. They've got a man underneath. Their turnaround shot won't drop for number 32. Smith's got the rebound for Connersville.
Man, he's missed a whole lot of those
that
shots.
Gillis can't believe it, I think, when he misses a shot.
You know, Grant's not liking the way he's playing right now. He's kind of upset with himself, but, you know, got to get back in it. We need you.
That's right. Here's Smith down, stopping from 10. Shot is missed. Both these teams cold on close-in shots, Ron.
Yeah, absolutely cold on close-in shots.
There's,
I mean, that's a shot you want to take.
20 firing and hitting a three for the Trojans, and that is Niam Williamson. He's a junior.
Yeah, who's that guy coming in there hitting threes like that? You know, I mean, we had Bumbleo and Frogel to worry about. Now we got Williamson hitting a three.
The lead is 7 for the Trojans. Spartans with the ball in traffic as Huffman throws it, tries a pass, and it's out of the reach of the intended receiver. Another turnover by Connersville.
Yeah, that's getting a little old here, and another turnover. Those are mistakes that we need to correct.
Trojans ball in the third period of play, and Newcastle with the ball and the lead. Connersville, their man-to-man defense. Here's Bumbleaw, a little jumper as he reaches over Bo Isaacs. And he's at 19 points, and his team's at 34. There's a loose ball as the Spartans let it get away from them, but they get it right back. Underneath Silcott, nice feed to him from Smith, and the Spartans get points 26 and 27. They're down by 7. 5 minutes, a little over 5 minutes to go here in the third period, and Kerry Brown wants a timeout. Apparently, what he told his guys at halftime isn't quite working yet, Ron.
No, it's not working at all. You know, unfortunately, you know, right there, that was a nice play. As you saw the replay of Grant throwing it right to Garrett and, you know, getting inside. But, you know, again, we've had some opportunity this half, and this almost three minutes gone of this half. We've had opportunities to get some points, and we squandered them by mental mistakes. We got to cut those down. Slow down a little bit. Reset right now. We have to reset right now, and let's play this game as if it's 0-0.
Yeah, the turnovers have really been costly here tonight.
Yeah, and missing some inside shots, but again, you know, so has Gillis. I mean, he's missed a half a dozen inside shots.
Yes.
So think if he'd got those shots, how much more that they would have. But again, how much more we would have if we would, you know, not make those mistakes.
Timeout's over. Newcastle breaking from around their coach, Daniel Cox. Gary Brown still has Spartans with him now. They break.
You know, not to take anything away from Newcastle, the way that they're playing defensively, because they are playing very well defensively.
Absolutely.
I mean, we've had a lot of mental mistakes, but they've had a lot of forced turnovers as well. They forced a lot of turnovers.
Newcastle ball. Trojans into front court. Here's number 20 getting an open shot and missing. And nice rebounding by Dalton Huffman for Connersville. Gives to Smith. Along the baseline, Noah Belt, close-in shot won't drop.
Yeah, that's right there.
Goes to Newcastle.
That's almost automatic for Noah from that range.
Here are the Trojans on the attack. Number 10 drives Silcott. In traffic, fires a shot, missed. Rebounding is Newcastle, and here's a shot missed by Newcastle. Isaac's rebounds. Both these teams are cold, Ron.
Yeah, absolutely.
The turnovers have been the difference, I think.
Yeah, the turnover's definitely been the difference. Right now, Bo's got to get it. There he
Isaac
is.
Hits a three for Connersville. Bo has 8 points, and the Spartans pull within four.
You know, again, hopefully that's the spark to bring us back. Again, we're down four. That's a foul on Gillis. That's
three. It. Makes a rare mistake tonight. That's the guy with 19 points, I think you said.
Oh, no, that's Gillis. That was a foul on Gillis right there. He elbowed Grant going around. And I've seen him do that on set and picks. He kind of throws his elbow out there, and he threw his elbow on Grant and got picked up.
Spartans will inbound in backcourt. Newcastle sets the defense.
you know, again, slow it down. Don't try to do – we can't get 4 points right now unless, you know, they foul on a three-point shot. But, again, just slow it down a little bit and, you know, no there's, need to – there's plenty
Smith
of time
and
to
Isaacs pulled out from the ball – from the goal. Silcott is on the side, gives out to Isaacs, now to Smith.
Well, you know, with our bigs out and their bigs out, we have the glass height inside. Ooh, that's
here's
beautiful.
Silcott feeding off Belt. Shot missed. Foul call.
Oh, they're going to give two shots to Hunter.
Foul on Newcastle. Two free throws.
Yeah, I see right here is Garrett. I mean, he's just going inside. He sees Hunter right there. And
Newcastle coach is an unhappy fellow here now.
He's not happy at
to
all.
To say the least. And Sullenberger at the free throw line for Connorsville. Oh. Rims his first one, drops off.
Got to make these free throws.
Right, we haven't been to the line very often tonight.
No. Been a couple of times and we've missed quite a few. No.
Second one is not good. Spartans missed two free throws and Newcastle has the rebound.
Yeah, an opportunity to cut the lead in half for this guy's
number
crazy.
Three. Missing for once. Ball knocked around, picked up by Newcastle.
That's our ball.
Off the fingertips of the Newcastle player as he was driving toward the basket, out of bounds to Connorsville.
Yeah, both teams very hungry, man. They're playing as if, you know, we're going to get right there. A nice hustle with Noah there against the bigger Gillis, and, you know, like that.
Here's Smith with the ball.
About to
out to Silcott. Sullenberger under the basket for Connorsville. Isaacs pulled out. Smith tries a three. Got it. Spartans pull within a point. It's 12 points. If the Spartans get the lead, this place will go crazy. Right?
Yeah, this place is going to go ballistic as the faithful is just trying to get
that. Number 10 missing for Newcastle. Spartans get the rebound. Here comes Smith.
Yeah, very nice play there from.
Ball knocked away by Newcastle boys. The Spartans try a pass. Out of bounds. It goes to Connorsville.
Now, let's not try to get too cute. Again, the faithful are just absolutely about ready to explode, as you said. And, you know, we got a new floor last year. We're going to need a new roof.
A basket by the Spartans would put them in front. Here's Smith trying a shot. Missed. A whistle stop play before
Gillis.
He fires.
Yeah, they're calling Gillis again.
There's a foul on 32 Gillis.
That's his third. We're
number three.
237.
Shooting foul. He'll come. No, he won't. I thought
they're taking
the ball game.
But Gillis has two or three fouls with 237 to go. They may have to get him out of here soon.
I would think they would, but we'll wait and see. Silcott inbounds for Connorsville. Takes a return pass. He's in the corner.
Wow,
there's
Grant's on
Smith
fire. He's feeling it.
Missing this one, and Newcastle with nobody for the Spartans under the basket grabs a rebound.
Yeah, I mean, again, this place would have went nuts if he'd have made it. But, again, you got to play it smart a little bit. Nobody was under the glass to get the rebound should you miss, and he did.
Right, it was a hurried shot, and he didn't really need to.
No, not at all.
Do that. Newcastle with the ball, leading by one here in the third period. Trojans got a man open and he misses, but a foul on Grant Smith.
They're going to call Hunter on that, I think.
Oh, is it Hunter? Okay.
Yep. Yeah,
right.
They're going to call Hunter right there. It's just enough as he came down, he caught him.
That's the first foul of the ball game of the second half on the Connorsville Spartans.
Yeah, they played
sending
very
to
clean.
The line, Jared Hurd fires and.
Wow, he didn't hit the rim.
You're right. He's a. Ball hit the left of the basket.
Yeah, that poor kid, he's trying to shake it off. That's embarrassing in front of these people.
Feel for him. Yeah. He's a senior at Newcastle.
Yeah, they got Bo.
There's a shot. Second one is good.
Yeah, they're calling Bo on that.
Another foul call on Isaacs.
Yeah, he gets another shot. They called Bo on that as he.
Kerry Smith wants an explanation, or Kerry Brown wants an explanation from the official.
Yeah, now it's Spartan ball, yeah.
Not sure what was going on. Anyway, the Spartans have the ball.
Yeah.
They're down by two.
Herds over there kidding around with Bennett. You know, hey, I don't know what I was thinking, missing that shot like that. At least he's got a good sense of humor on it. He's still smiling over that.
There's Smith, got an open jumper from the free throw
nice
lane.
Hustle
won't go, and the rebound battle is won by Newcastle. Here come the Trojans. There's number three.
That's a foul.
Beating off. There's a charge called on Newcastle.
Yep, I knew that. I mean, that's good defensive positioning there from Grant to get that foul called.
Spartan get the ball in backcourt.
You know, again, we can tie it right here, take the lead with the three, but again, just
here's,
calm down and relax.
Silcott.
Who I thought Noah was going to take it.
I thought he was going to too, but he hands off to Silcott.
Well, you have a 6'6 guy.
Behind the free throw circle. Drives the lane. Feeds off to Belt.
Here's yeah, there.
Shot ooh. On the way by.
Oh, beautiful.
Noah wow. Belt, which is missed, and Smith tried to tap it up and in, but it wouldn't go for him, and Newcastle comes out with a rebound. Here are the Trojans.
Yeah, slow it down.
A loose basketball. I thought a foul was going to be called on Connors.
Yeah, I thought so too Spartan. There for a moment.
Yes, there comes CHS. Isaacs, here's Belt from the side.
Get to
missing.
Follow your shot. If you follow your shot, you could have possibly
right.
got that rebound.
Newcastle grabs the rebound.
Yeah,
we're under a minute left to play in the third period.
Yeah, that drives me crazy when they shoot the shot and then they start going down before the, and then the ball rebounds close to where, or with, goes
Newcastle
where you could have been.
Will hold it till the final shot.
Oh, I don't know. I mean, it,
ball taken out by Huntley, number four. Back to Bumbleaw. He'll take the shot, I'm sure. He is being guarded by Smith. Bumbleaw starts his drive, stops, comes back out. Good ball handling by the
very
Newcastle
good ball handling.
Two.
Yeah,
here's
was,
a bump
a timeout.
By Smith. Guarding too closely.
Oh, I thought he called a timeout. Caught it on Grant.
Oh.
I thought that they had called a timeout.
That's the first on Grant Smith. It'll give Newcastle the ball out of bounds. Clock starts. 14 seconds to be played. The ball being held by Gillis, number 32.
Yeah, they're going to have to hustle there, you know.
He goes to Bumbleaw.
Horrible time management.
Picks him up here. Bumbleaw firing long and missing as the third period ends. Newcastle 35 and the Spartans 33. The Spartans had a 10-point third period. Newcastle only scored 6 runs.
Yeah, a much improved quarter, obviously, for the Spartans. Again, they had some mental mistakes that they need to correct. And again, that's why I believe they're not in the lead. But again, you know, Gillis has missed a lot of inside shots as well. We got to make sure that he doesn't start getting hot from inside.
Yes.
Just got to cut out those mental mistakes and start playing the way that we started playing towards that last half of that quarter right there. And, you know, I really believe if we play the way we've been playing, we should be able to walk out of here with a victory. But again, you know, the Newcastle Trojans, they're hungry.
Yeah, yes, indeed, and they want revenge.
Yeah, they do want revenge.
After those two losses to the Spartans last year.
Yeah, that's still definitely fresh on their minds.
Timeout's over. 2-point lead for Newcastle as we begin the final 8 minutes here tonight at Spartan Bowl on the TV3 Game of the Week.
I mean, this crowd, you know, for a weeknight game, this crowd is just electric. And,
absolutely.
You know, if we take the lead right here, again, the roof's coming off this place.
Here's Silcott with the ball being guarded. Over to Smith. Now Silcott. Here's Grant Smith. Driving to the free throw circle. Coming
oh, he's
out,
going in there,
Silcott,
yes.
Lays it up and in, and we're tied.
Yeah, I mean, I knew that right away. I mean, he saw that little bit of an opening. You know what happens
yes.
when he sees an opening, Fran. When he sees that opening, he's going in.
The Spartans have caught Newcastle in the scoring. Now they need to play defense.
Yeah, again, don't go asleep defensively.
Yes. Number 42, the ball handler, Jared Hurd. He has the ball. Silcott picks him up on the guard. Trojans working the ball. get a signal from their coach. Makes a circular motion, so I would think that means
rotate.
Work the ball.
yeah, keep going, rotate out. Yeah, I'm not quite sure that Newcastle I mentioned earlier, that you know they probably want to slow this down a little bit, but I don't think that's their style to hold
Here's
the ball this
shot,
much.
A two-point jumper from number three, Bumbalaw. He's at 21 points. Team's up by two as Connersville walks it across the timeline. Here's Silcott driving down. Turnaround jumper is short. Silcott. The rebound goes to Belt, loose basketball, and it's going to be ruled.
Yeah, that's just, you know, you can't miss that.
Well, that was not a good series.
No, not a good series at all. You know, again, we've been playing from behind this entire game. And,
yes.
You know, we tied it. It's just, you know, again, when you're playing behind almost the entire game, that's going to be on both.
Foul called on the Spartans. Number 52 will be charged with the foul, Bo Isaacs.
You know, Bo kind of thought that the Newcastle player bumped into him.
A non-shooting foul. Yeah, we'll give Newcastle the ball under their basket.
We've played very clean, you know, as far as fouls.
Newcastle control. Ball comes out to Williamson. Now number 10. Froge handles the basketball, backs off. Silcott picks up the guard. Oh, there's a loose ball. Bad pass by Newcastle. Spartans have the basketball.
Slowing
it up court. Here's Silcott taking the feed from Smith. 5.5 minutes to go into tonight's game.
Go.
There's Silcott starting his drive.
Sure.
Losing the basketball out of bounds. A Spartan, and it's Newcastle basketball.
Yeah, not sure. Yeah, I mean, it looked like a foul, right? But
I thought he was caught in the arm, I thought.
Yeah, that's what I thought, too. But nonetheless, the Zebras didn't catch it, and they're the ones that matter.
That's right, and they're closer to it than we are. So. Now the Trojans set up the play. 32. Well,
that's...
There's
I was going to say that.
And is that a charge call?
Yeah, definitely a charge call. Gillis, that's his fourth. They got to get him out of there. You know, that's his fourth
32,
foul.
32, Mason Gillis.
Yeah, that's his fourth. They're going to have to, I mean, right there, I mean, that was a nice play there from Grant and Bo.
The coach of Newcastle reminds a player he has four fouls.
Yeah, be careful. You know, he can't play aggressive anymore. They're definitely going to need him with, you know, under 5 minutes to go in this ball game.
Isaacs tries a three, which will be off the mark.
No, they're going to call it on Garrett.
A foul called on Silcott of Connersville.
Again, and Newcastle is
the fourth team foul, first on Garrett, but Newcastle has the ball.
Yeah, Newcastle is letting us the door wide open for us to tie and take the lead.
They had a lead of two.
They've only scored 8 points this half.
Final minutes in the final quarter of this ball game. Trojans working the ball underneath. Whistle stops play. Is this
it'll be on Hunter.
Connersville?
Yeah, yes, on Hunter.
Number five. On Hunter Sullenbarger. That will be his second and Spartan's fifth non-shooting foul. Newcastle ball. They work it in to number 32.
Oh, nice.
Has the ball knocked away from him, but he picks
it, nice
gets it
back
and a little jump shot from the free throw circle. Free throw lane by Gillis is good, and Newcastle goes up by four. Here the Spartans, long shot by Belt is missed. And the rebound goes to Newcastle.
Yeah, this right here, we have to stop them right here. Absolutely, positively have to stop them. We cannot get under 4 minutes to go. We cannot get down more than two buckets.
Here's number 10 firing a shot. Number 8 for Froge. And the Trojans go up 41-36.
Very good. Number 10.
41-35, rather. Here's a,
oh, they got a technical, and I didn't see it.
Who's coming up here now?
I don't know what's happening, but they called a technical on Froge or Fogel.
I'm not sure. I guess it's Froge, I think.
Yeah, he apparently he's been tripping people. Yeah, he's tripping.
Foul, yeah. Technical on Froge, 10.
I think he's going to go to Duke.
As the official rule, he's been tripping people.
Yeah.
So Hunter Sullenberger will be at the free throw line.
So he must have tripped Hunter. Oh, man, Hunter, that's three you've missed. Got to make them.
Not a time to be missing free throws.
No, not at all. We get the ball. If he makes it right here, we're down five. We get the ball. Good job.
That's a free throw shooting. 3 points for Hunter tonight.
Now, they're saying that was an intentional foul there from. So I thought it was a tee. I thought they teed him. Apparently, you know. An intentional foul is what the ref said to Terry. And
Spartans have the ball down by 5 points.
You know, still plenty of time in this ball game to make a comeback, but we, again, can't make any mistakes at all.
Isaacs, yes. Three. Nice shot by Bo Isaacs from behind the free throw circle in three-point land. He has 11 points. And Newcastle will call for a timeout. They are playing with a lead of two here in the final quarter of tonight's ball game from Spartan Bowl.
Yeah, we have, again, Newcastle has given us plenty of opportunity to stay in this ball game, and we have to capitalize every time we force a turnover, every time we get the defensive glass. We have to capitalize and turn these into points. There's just no other way to do
it. That's right. I mean, you're right. You cannot turn this ball over anymore.
No.
Turnovers. I mean, every possession.
We have to score.
That's right. I mean, that's the story here. As we've trailed in this ball game, tried to play catch up all night long.
I mean, eventually, when you play catch up too much, you get a little too tired at the end. And,
yes.
And that's what I was afraid of when they went up five on us, and I thought, oh my goodness, you know, we cannot be down that much. But then now we've cut it back down to two, and you know, we absolutely positively again have to play perfect basketball on both sides of the ball.
3:24 on the clock.
Garrett must have jammed his finger. He was getting taped on his index finger on his left hand.
Newcastle will inbound. Goes into Bumbalaw.
Yeah,
Smith
Grant
picks him up on the guard.
Okay, Grant wanted that one big time.
He would have liked to have intercepted an inbound pass, I know.
No, I would have loved it.
There's number 10 with the ball, Froge. Still caught on him. Spartans in their man-to-man defense. Trojans.
Oh, there's another etch away from the ball. Foul.
Ball goes
or go 5 second call.
To the Spartans.
Yeah. Okay, I thought he was calling a foul on somebody. Yeah, I like that. You know, we're in the bonus, so that's good, but we got to start making our free throws if we get to the line.
Here comes Connorsville on the attack. Spartans looking in a 2-3 offense. Silcott goes to Belt. Silcott in the corner, starts to drive down.
Our defense gave us another opportunity to tie this ball game, Fran. We have to take it now.
Here's Smith with the ball, driving on the Newcastle boy. Feeds over to Sullenberger.
I didn't even see Hunter over there. I thought he was throwing it out of bounds.
Silcott now goes to Belt. A little over 2 minutes to be played in tonight's ball game. Here's Isaac. Feeds off to Sullenberger, missing. Fight for the rebound, taken by.
Yes, oh, that was beautiful.
By Smith, he puts it up, and it finally dropped. He has 14, Grant Smith, and we are tied at 41.
The last time we tied this ball game, Fran, we went into a little bit of a lull. We definitely cannot do that right now. We absolutely, positively have to play perfect defense right now and get a bucket down on the other side of the floor.
Newcastle has the ball. Here's 10 firing and missing, right, and the rebound goes to the Spartans. The Silcott, fast breaking down court. Falls down, slides across the end line, and it's out of bounds to Newcastle.
Sometimes adrenaline can be your worst enemy as you get so excited you try to force it too much. That was a forced, you know, trying to do a little bit too much right there to get that lead and play off the emotion of the faithful. Watch this, Grant Smith. I mean, watch this. This is beautiful as it just a little off there from Hunter and, you know, tipped around. You see Grant right there, and he just, I mean, one fluid motion, Fran. That reminds me of your play back in the day.
Oh, yes, sure.
And it just rolled around the glass. That right there, rolled around the rim. That's beautiful. Unbelievable.
41-41 with a minute and 36 seconds left to be played in this ball game.
Our defense, we gave up 29 points in that first half, and Newcastle's only scored 12 this second half. Our defense has clamped it down, and I've said it so many times on both boys and girls game, you need to reward that defense offensively, and you know, we just haven't got over that hump. Right now is the opportunity. We've got to get over the hump. Now we put more pressure on our defense because of that turnover.
Timeout's just about over here at Spartan Bowl tonight. Hope you're enjoying the TV3 game of the week. Connorsville trying for victory number 14 here tonight. Newcastle for number 11.
I tell you what, but when was the last time, as you see the faithful, they're going a little crazy. When was the last time both teams have came in here with only one loss apiece?
I can't remember, as I said in the opening, 23 wins and two losses between these two ball clubs. Yeah.
The pride for both teams is definitely back.
It is Newcastle basketball, a minute and a half to be played. Let's see if they eat some clock or not. Ron, what do you think?
They're going to set up a good shot, obviously. They're not going
right.
They got to be patient.
Timeout taken.
Yeah, Newcastle called timeout. Again, that was great defense there from Garrett. We're going to see this. We're going to have a lot more turnover, or a lot more timeouts.
It's a quick timeout here, a 30-second version.
Yeah, again, our defense right there suffocating there. Frogel right there. I mean, we, again, got to force a turnover or get the defensive glass. Absolutely, we have to. A little future Spartan net right there. You know, again, the faithful here, they're just absolutely just – they're hungry for a victory. The boys haven't been here in over a month and a half.
That's right. It's been a middle of December when they played here last. And now we are.
So this crowd is, I mean, they want it badly, probably maybe more than the boys.
Newcastle puts it in play. This is number 3 handling the ball, Bumbleaw. Now to Gillis. Isaac's on him. To set up the play. I think, Ron, we're in the final minute of this
We are.
Ball game, so it's apparent that Newcastle is.
They want the last shot, or they want
The ball over and back off the hands of number 3, and Cottonville will have the basketball.
Carey's calling timeout.
Tied at 41, and Connorsville will take a timeout to set up a play.
Yeah, definitely right there. I mean, that was just about time Newcastle makes that mental mistake right there, Fran. As you see, I mean, that's an average pass that he makes 99%.
That's right.
And
number 3 was the last guy I thought would make a mistake that.
Yeah, and he made that mistake again. They've given us plenty of opportunity to take the lead. I mean, it's almost like they want us to win this ball game. Do we want to win this ball game? Obviously we do, but we got to not do too much right now in the last 43 seconds. Calm the nerves and just play the ball game. Don't make a turnover. Make a basket. Absolutely right.
Okay, it will be Spartan basketball. Again, the clock shows 43.2 seconds.
Can't make a mistake at all. Wow.
Isaac looks for somebody open, finally gets it into Sullenberger. Over to Smith. See what play Kerry Brown drew up for Connersville.
I would
he
love.
Goes to Belt, 33 seconds.
Love to see Garrett get inside, draw the foul, maybe Noah
goes
get
to
inside.
Smith, out to Silcott. Now Belt, Hunterberger, 20 seconds on the clock.
All right, this is it Smith right here.
Brings the ball out to Silcott. 12 seconds.
No mistake.
11, 10. Fans are cheering.
Gotta go, gotta go, gotta go.
Let's go.
Gotta go now.
Under a few seconds remaining. Up and shot missed.
Oh, that was unbelievable.
And the horn sounds, and it's overtime here tonight.
Just a little too late right there. I mean, wow, that was unbelievable. You see right here, Garrett streaking inside with 3 seconds to go. Wanted that foul right there, didn't get the call. And Grant's last second
that's
shot.
That's what he was hoping for.
Didn't go in. Wow. Yeah, that was, again, you can't take away that play. Again, just maybe started a little bit too late. But, man, oh, man, I tell you what, the Spartans, they better just breathe a sigh of relief to be in this ball game right now at 41.
I think you're right. 41-41. We'll have 4 minutes put on the clock, and we'll getting to the overtime period here very, very soon.
Yeah, you know, again, we have to just calm down, try not to be overly aggressive, cut out the mental mistakes, and make them pay. Got to make them pay. Every time we force a turnover, every time we get the defensive glass, we got to make them pay.
Both these teams have played one overtime game, Ron. The Spartans won theirs over Shelbyville. And it was Newcastle losing in an overtime, 79-77 to Mount Vernon at Fortville.
Indeed, was their defense played in that game? This is a
so
defensive.
The Spartans have won in overtime, and Newcastle has lost in overtime.
Yeah, this
we'll
is.
See who wins this overtime.
Yeah. Faithful, of course, we know who they want to win.
Okay, jumping center will be Smith for Connersville and Gillis for Newcastle.
Gillis got it last time.
And it's bounced around. The Spartans win this one.
Yes, definitely got a score right here. Absolutely
Still
positively.
Gillis to Smith. Grant dribbles the ball around, gives to Isaac. He's pulled out. Number 40, Smith. Think the Spartans will work the ball. They'll try to get a high percentage shot.
Oh, yeah, I
would
hope so.
I don't think they'll try anything wild. But well, you never know, just as I say that. As I say that, Isaac hits one from the corner for three. He has 14 points, and the Spartans have a first lead of this ball game.
That's unbelievable right there. I mean, who would have thought Bo got nice.
Oh, nice steal by the Spartan. Silcott, fast breaking down court, gets rid of his defender, puts it up and in, and the Spartans go up by five. 13 points for Silcott, and this crowd is
deafening. Yeah, this crowd is deafening as the faithful, again, they're hungry as the boys are for a victory. We haven't seen these boys in, well, since last year.
Here's number three driving down.
Oh, Noah got
loses
the rebound.
The ball as he goes up for a shot. No foul called. He wanted to be fouled.
Oh, yeah.
Silcott brings it across the timeline.
Yeah, he definitely wanted a foul right there. Didn't get it, and Noah got the rebound.
Oh, they work underneath to Smith. Work the ball to him. Grant tries the shot. He's fouled.
And I think that's Gillis. That's Gillis's last. Gillis is out.
Foul called on Williamson.
Oh, no, Williamson.
Newcastle.
Okay, I thought my bad on that. Maybe I was wishful thinking.
Grant Smith will be at the line for two free throws.
I still can't believe Gillis is in there with four fouls, but again, overtime, you got to have your big guy in there.
Absolutely. He makes his team go. The free throw is good. Spartans 47-41.
Who would have
second
thought?
Shot on its way. Good. a 7-point lead for the Spartans in overtime with 2.5 minutes to be played. 16 points for Smith. Newcastle on the attack. Loose ball by the Trojans. Down court, Smith. He is fouled as he goes. No, oh, they're loose. Ruling he loses control of the ball. Yeah. Out of bounds, Newcastle.
I don't know if we got a replay on this. As we see it coming up, we'll find out if he was hacked or not. No, that's all ball, and that's off Grant. Yeah, that was a good call, unfortunately.
Up court, Newcastle. We're in overtime. Trojans setting up a play with a little over 2 minutes to be played.
You know, I like Gillis's aggression on that, playing with four fouls and went after it. He's given it his all.
Here's Gillis, a turnaround shot that is good. Banks one in. He's fouled.
They got Bo on that one.
Right. Bo Isaacs picks up the foul.
Again, we still got plenty of time to go. We need to keep that momentum. Let's not just be a momentum killer.
Here's Gillis at the line. His team is down by five. He has one free throw coming. It is up and good. 48-44, Spartans. 11 points for the Newcastle boy, Gillis. Here's Silcott driving the free throw lane, feeding out. Spartans working the ball. Nice pass work by Connersville.
I thought Bo was going to take that. I thought Hunter may have taken his too, but hey, we got the lead. Let's go ahead and eat some clock.
Down to a minute 35.
Who knows? Wide open. Noah, I mean,
Spartans just playing keep away right now.
Yeah, why not? Why not?
Well, absolutely. This is smart.
But I tell you what, Noah was wide open there a few times.
And they make Newcastle foul, and they did.
Yeah, that's fruit.
Isaac will be at the free throw line.
Yeah, we got to get him in there right now. I mean, Bo, you know, he's get these shots right now. I'm not sure what he's shooting free throw percentage wise, Fran, but that guy's been
Bo
very
Isaacs
good all year. No.
This is his free throw and Newcastle rebounds.
Wow,
that doesn't come back to haunt him.
Yeah, terrible free
Here
throw shooting.
Driving
tonight.
Down, falling down, loose basketball.
That's their ball.
And it will be, what's the official's rule?
Oh, it's a jump ball. It's Newcastle's ball, and they call a timeout. That's a 30-second timeout. See if we can see. He didn't have the ball.
It was going to be a held ball, I thought. But
yeah, they called a held. Yeah. Yeah, that faithful giving the Zebras some business right there.
Yeah, the official. The fans in the stands are
it's a full
letting the officials know.
Yeah,
we aren't happy with their job here tonight.
No, they're not. Again, we're up by four. Got to, I mean, they have the ball. Possession arrow will be ours after this right now. Again, got to get the glass, got to get the free throw. Wow, this, I tell you what, this game is everything it's been advertised and then some. I mean,
that's right.
Then
well,
some.
At the beginning, we said it had all the ingredients of being a great game.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is an instant classic. This needs to be on ESPN. And we got Ocho ESPN over there. That's unbelievable. They're here covering it.
Timeout's over, and
it's been a long time out.
Resume play.
I think they took a 30 and a 4.
That's a long time out.
Yeah. Well, I know one of the refs came over and said full, and I thought maybe, okay, that maybe he mistaken and thought it was a full initially, but I think it was a 30 and a 4.
I think so. Newcastle ball. Trojans down by 4 points.
Got to get the glass. Got to get the rebound. That's
ball
wow.
Is put in play.
Grant tipped it, didn't even know it.
There's number 20 firing a shot and hitting a two-pointer. That's Bryce Webb who scored to cut the Spartans' lead to 2. It was 7.
Right, yeah, we got to come back.
Yeah, the Spartans need to keep control of the basketball. Don't make them foul. There it is.
Yep.
Smith will be at the free throw line.
Got to sink these shots. Every time we're at the line, got to sink the shots. Every time.
Grant is a 78% free throw shooter. see if he can up that percentage here. Ron.
Oh, I want him to right now. Oh, man, I tell
this
you what.
The first one. Spartans are missing costly free throws.
Way
tonight.
Too many free throws. Way too many.
You know. Really crucial. Second one is good. Spartans up by three, but Newcastle has the ball quickly across the timeline, driving the baseline and laying it up and in is Williamson for the Trojans. Spartans up court, protecting a lead of one with 30 seconds to be played. Connorsville, they'll foul, I'm sure Newcastle will. Here's Isaacs. Spartans just trying to protect the ball. Isaacs is fouled. The official is telling the
Newcastle
coach
to, set down.
To back off from Newcastle. He was out of the area that the coaches are allowed to roam in. Here's Smith at the free throw line again. Let's see what Grant can do this time. He
wow.
misses.
Man, this is unbelievable. Yeah,
gets a second shot coming up.
Yeah, we're going to have to, work on our free throws.
This one is good. The Spartans go up by two. The Newcastle has the ball. And, of course, we know what would happen. Three would win this game.
Yeah.
And it's a timeout taken by Newcastle.
You know, no matter what happens, if we win this ball game, if we lose this ball game, what's going to happen is we're going to be at the free throw line during practice.
That's for
what's
sure.
going to happen. I mean, we've missed way
yeah,
too
we've
many
seen,
free throws.
We've seen guys tonight that don't miss free throws.
And miss free
throws. Free
yeah.
throws.
Miss
right.
a lot of free throws. I mean, we definitely.
Right, right.
I mean, without question, need to. Wow, we need to stop them here because now we're letting them back in the ball game like they let us back in the ball
right,
game.
That's right. That's right. Well, you make free throws and you rebound and you play defense and you'll win.
That's exactly right. And we've done all that. I mean, we've got a lot of the glass defensively. Again, the costly mistakes. Now it's the costly missed free throws.
Absolutely. I mean, it'll come back to haunt these guys.
Yeah, we cannot miss that many free throws and expect to stay in this ball game. The fact that we're up by two says a whole lot about the way our defense really has played.
Yes. Okay, timeout's over. We have 14.8 seconds on the clock. It will be
Newcastle ball.
Putting the ball in play. You know what's on their mind.
Ron. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, number 20, Williamson has, you know, he
will
has
they
scored
go
7
for
points.
Two to tie or three to win? Let's see.
I don't know. I think if I were them, I'd probably go for the tie.
Have another overtime, right. Here's number three. He drives the ball down. Here's a shot, which is missed.
Go.
Rebound
yes.
to Isaac as Newcastle misses a free throw. Foul call. Isaac will be at the line.
Got to make this right here to put it almost out of reach. Got to make them both.
Williamson charged with the foul as the Spartan fans going nuts here tonight. And Isaacs will step to the line.
You know, I've said it before, and I'm going to say it again, how blessed we are to be in this facility, Fran, to be able to, and right there, look at that faithful right there. She's all excited. She's rooting for both.
Should I say it, Ron? He's a 90% free throw shooter.
Yeah, don't jinx him, Fran.
I bet if I'd say that and he'd miss these. Yeah.
You said it after he made the shot. Again, they're icing him.
Spartan fans would be waiting for me.
Yeah, that's right. They'd be waiting for you afterwards. You know, again, they're trying to ice Bo. Again, make this shot, the ball game's over.
Absolutely, the Spartans would have a lead of four.
Yeah, just let them shoot
the ball. With 4.5 seconds on the clock.
Yeah, I mean, unbelievable. I mean, really, let's be honest. When we watch this ball game and the way the Spartans just seem like they squandered every opportunity to get in this ball game, you thought that we didn't deserve to win. I mean, late in that fourth quarter, we had so many opportunities to tie it and take the lead. We finally tied it, and we were never able to get off that hump to take the lead. And we finally did. We finally tied it.
In that fourth period, we finally got a lead.
Yeah.
I mean, it was unreal.
And then, you know, again, they came back to tie the ball game to get us in overtime, and then we just exploded right out of the gate.
Yeah, we had seven quick points in the first minute and a half of the overtime.
But you knew Newcastle wasn't going to go away. We knew that they were going to fight and come back.
They're not about to do that.
No, I mean, there's no way that they would have rolled over and went to sleep on that. And they came back, and Bo's right here. We're going to put them away right here.
Bo Isaacs will be at the free throw line. Second free throw coming up. Spartans with a lead of three. 4.5 seconds to be played in this overtime period. Here's Isaacs, ready to go. Takes aim, fires, yes. Got it.
That right there is the ball game. Just let them go. Don't
let
them.
Let them shoot. Don't foul. Let them hit a three, and they did.
Yeah.
That's a wow.
Yeah.
As the game ends, there's a three-pointer put in by Newcastle. That was 3-1.
Yeah, that was a three-pointer.
Yes,
absolutely.
I thought so. And the Spartans escape here tonight. I think I ought to just say escape.
Yeah.
52-51 over this Newcastle team that was determined to come in here and get a victory. And
yeah, they wanted that victory.
They had that on their mind that we are going to win this ball game tonight.
Yeah.
And they played like it, but the Spartans picked up their game, but not until the fourth period.
Yeah, exactly. Again, you know, the Spartans played not good offensively, defensively. They played what we expected. I mean, they really clamped it down that second half. You know, when they gave up 29 points, that was uncharacteristically bad for the Spartans. But again, they clamped it down. But again, the offense never took the opportunity to take the lead until the very minute. I mean, I don't have any more nails. I mean, I've been biting my nails, and that's, again, these boys did not give up. These boys did not you know, hang their head from all their mistakes. They just kept grinding away. Again, Bo in the very beginning had some terrible three-point shots.
Yes.
But he came back and was putting some daggers in that second half. Again, you keep playing the way that you know how to play, and eventually it will start working itself out. And the Spartans stayed true to the course, and they absolutely positively, without question, they
It was a lot of scoring in that overtime, Ron.
Oh, yeah, a lot of scoring.
The Spartans put in 11 points, and Newcastle put in 10.
Yeah,
so
I mean,
it was really unusual for that many points to be scored in a four-minute overtime.
Yeah.
52-51 is the final score here tonight. Spartans get victory number 14. And for the Newcastle Trojans, only their second loss of the season. They go back to Newcastle with a record of 10-2. You got some scoring?
Yes, I do. For the Newcastle Trojans, they were led by Luke Bumbleow's 21 points. He scored 17 of that in the first quarter, so they put the clamps down on that guy in the second half in the overtime. David Frogel had 10 points. Nia Williamson had 7. And Mason Gillis had 11 for Newcastle Trojans, 51. I think it's 51. I can't even add. I don't have any idea. For the Connors of Spartans, they were led by Grant Smith's 18 points. Bo Isaacs had 16. Noah Belt chipped in 2. Hunter Sollenbarger had 3. And Garrett Silcott had 13 for the Spartans.
Big win for CHS here tonight, 52-51 over the Newcastle Trojans in overtime. And I know those kids have to be very happy, the Spartans right now.
Oh, absolutely.
To be able to win this ball game.
Absolutely, they have to feel happy. Again, they played this game as if they didn't really want to win it. And what I mean by that is that, you know, we just never really, you know, took advantage of the opportunities that Newcastle gave us to take the lead and win this ball game by more than we wanted. But again, they didn't quit. They didn't let the mistakes keep them down. They just kept charging away and plugging away, and they walked out of here with a victory. A very hard-fought, good victory for the Spartans.
Played through some really what I thought costly turnovers.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, we made a lot of mental mistakes that we have not seen the Spartans make in a very, very long time. And again, you know, again, it's just being back on this floor for the first time in a long time. The nerves, the excitement, you know, gets to the boys. And again, they, you know, righted the ship at the right time. Unbelievable.
Spartans were behind 2 points as we began the fourth period, 35-33. But they played well and were able to make this ball game go into overtime, 41-41 at the end of regulation play. Again, a 52-51 win for the Spartans. Our crew tonight on cameras, Megan Murphy, Jacob Bentley, Joe Minrick, and Mitch Richardson. We thank those guys and gal for all the hard work they do. Our director and replay was by Devin Hamilton. The scoreboard graphics and audio by Justin Roberts. Our next Spartan telecast will be when the girls entertain Pendleton Heights here at Spartan Bowl. We're going to have some comments from the Spartan coach here in very shortly. Again, the final score in overtime, Connersville 52 and Newcastle 51. and we'll have Kerry Brown's comments here coming up soon. You are watching Spartan Basketball on TV3. Coach, you're all smiles, I think.
Great game. Great fan support, great crowd, great atmosphere on Tuesday night. Overtime game, I think the fans got their money's worth and the Spartans won. So, you know, nobody's going home complaining, I don't think.
When the Spartans finally got that lead in the fourth period, this place, it went crazy.
Great atmosphere. I think the six-man helped motivate our kids. I know they were fired up just to be playing tonight against Newcastle, a tremendous team. But you're right, when we took the lead, I think the roof about came off of this place. So we're appreciative of the support we get from our fans here at home, and hopefully they'll come out Saturday and help us with an important conference game against Batesville on Saturday.
What did you tell your guys at halftime? You were down, and you had a number three guy that was putting them in from all over the floor. What happened?
Well, we made one switch defensively, and that took care of number three. I mean, he's still probably – I don't know what he ended up with, but Grant – we switched Grant Smith onto him, and Grant's length bothered him. And then offensively, you know, we struggled a little bit. We didn't shoot it well, but we told them to rely on one another, you know, what we've done all year, instead of trying to do it themselves to make the extra pass. And eventually knocked down enough shots and actually got up seven in the overtime with the basketball.
Yes.
And he finished the game out pretty well.
Threes weren't dropping tonight, were they?
Not early, they weren't. But thankfully, we played good enough defense. You know, what was it at the end of regulation? 41 all.
Yes.
And they're a good basketball team. They were averaging 67 points a game coming in. So our defense, you know, kept us in the game, and we finally, you know, knocked down enough shots to get the win.
Well, it was a great victory for the Spartans. And I know Newcastle came to town with wanting to wipe a couple of losses from last year off their mark.
Well, I think they might have been extra motivated because of that. Mm-hmm. I guess we just made them more motivated going into the next time if we have to play them. It'll be okay if somebody else knocks them off for me. But, no, our kids will have all the confidence in the world now. You know, beat them twice last year, beat them here this year. So it is what it is. We'll see who the draw pits us against in late February and early March. But great job by our kids tonight.
You talked about the Batesville team coming. That's an important conference game.
It is. We're undefeated in the conference right now. They've only got one loss. It's a big game for us Saturday night against a team that came in here last year and played us really tough. I think it ended up being about an eight-point game. So, you know, we're going to have three good practices between now and Saturday and come out and have a good performance and execute well on Saturday night.
Your game with Muncie Central, Coach, tell us a little bit about that.
We shot it really well. We played good defense as well. But for the game, we shot 60-some percent, I think, from two-point range. Mm-hmm. We shot 50% from the three-point line. And through three quarters, we had held them to 24 points, I believe it was.
Yes.
So it was a combination of our offense and our defense both clicking at the same time on the same night.
That game was just a couple of days ago, so what did you do a lot physically, or was mostly emotional getting ready for tonight?
We played them Saturday night, and then we had one practice Monday night to get ready for tonight. We did a normal scout and report night where we talked about them, but we also did a few breakdown drills to try to get ready for them, and a lot of shooting. We didn't kill them. We didn't run a lot. We didn't work them over the hard, but more mental than it was physical.
Yes, that's what I thought.
Yes, sir.
Coach, thanks a million for your time. Congratulations to you and to those 10 guys that wear the red and white of the Spartans.
Thank you. Appreciate the coverage.
Thanks, Coach. Coach Kerry Brown joining us here for the final wrap of tonight's ball game. The Spartans in overtime, 52-51 over the Newcastle Trojans. For Ryan Wiley, this is Fran Schumel thanking you as always for watching Spartan Sports on TV3.